During this spread of COVID-19, her elders asked to follow the safety measures. I think you are following. In addition to that, they used to say that you must have, or you should have, or you should take the food items which are rich in vitamin C. Why? Because these food items protect us against immune system deficiency. That's why they are asking you to take such kind of food items. Can you say some examples, common examples, that you can say the fruit items which contain vitamin C? Yes, your guess is correct. The lemon, orange, etc. Lemon, what is the taste? You know, it is sour in taste. Generally, the acids are sour in taste, so they contain acid. For example, tomato, vinegar and tamarind are some other examples which contain acids. So they are acidic in nature due to the presence of oxalic acid, acetic acid and tartaric acid respectively. You have already learned in the lower classes that acids are sour in taste. They turn blue litmus paper into red. They provide or they produce H plus ions when they dissolve in water or aqueous solution. All these acids are known as organic acids because they are found in natural substances. Apart from the organic acids, that is oxalic acid, acetic acid, tartaric acid, etc., there are many inorganic acids, that is mineral acids like sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid and nitric acid. These acids are prepared artificially and are available in laboratories to perform various experiments. If a person suffering from acidity, what will you do? You used to say that the person should take antacid. Why? Antacid is the base, that is, for example, milk of magnesia, that is magnesium hydroxide, which will neutralize or nullify the effect of acidity. So the person will be relieved from the pain. What is the taste of the base? It is bitter in taste. Bases are bitter in taste, and if you are touching, they are soapy to touch. These are the properties of bases. When they dissolve in water, they dissociate to give OH- ions or hydroxyl ions. Are the term when they are in the compound, they are named by hydroxide. Acid and base, when they combine, they form the neutral substance salt. So this reaction is called neutralization. That is, an acid reacts or combines with the base to give salt and water is called neutralization reaction. These are the things already you have learned in lower classes. Now, in chapter number 2, that is, in acids, bases and salts, we are going to discuss some more properties, that is, chemical properties of acids, bases and the salts, nature, preparation of salt, and also the water of crystallization. We will learn in detail about the acids, bases and salts in the next class. Now, let us discuss some questions that in the book exercises in chapter number 1.
Balance the following chemical equations. A. HNO3 plus CaOH twice gives CaNO3 twice plus H2O. B. NaOH plus H2SO4 gives Na2SO4 plus H2O. C. NaCl plus AgNO3 gives AgCl plus NaNO3. D. BaCl2 plus H2SO4 gives BaSO4 plus HCl. Answer A. The chemical equation HNO3 plus CaOH twice gives CaNO3 twice plus H2O. CaNO3 is a big molecule having oxygen atoms in large number. Therefore, the oxygen atoms should be balanced first. 2HNO3 plus CaOH twice gives CaNO3 twice plus 2H2O. During balancing of oxygen atoms, other atoms get balanced automatically. So, this is the balanced chemical equation. B. The chemical equation NaOH plus H2SO4 gives Na2SO4 plus H2O. In this equation, the H2SO4 and Na2SO4 are large molecules having large number of oxygen atoms. But the oxygen atoms are already balanced and hydrogen atoms are not balanced. So, let us balance the hydrogen atoms. 2NaOH plus H2SO4 gives Na2SO4 plus 2H2O. During balancing the hydrogen atoms, other atoms automatically get balanced. So, this is the balanced chemical equation. NaCl plus AgNO3 gives AgCl plus NaNO3. In this reaction, the number of different atoms are equal in reactants and products. Therefore, the equation is balanced. D. BaCl2 plus H2SO4 gives BaSO4 plus HCl. We see that all the atoms are balanced except Cl and hydrogen, which can be balanced by multiplying HCl by 2. So, the balanced chemical equation is BaCl2 plus H2SO4 gives BaSO4 plus 2HCl. One more question answer. Question number 18. Why do we apply paint on iron articles? We apply paint on iron articles to prevent the iron article from rusting. For rusting, the oxygen and moisture are necessary conditions. So, by applying the paint, we can prevent the exposure of iron articles to air and moisture. Ultimately, rusting is prevented.